Hi, welcome back to the series where I've been sharing stories to help you build your story bank. Today's story is about Charles Pellerin. Charles was the director of astrophysics at NASA, where he led the team that was responsible for perhaps the biggest scientific screw-up in history. In 1990, Charles and his team sent up a telescope worth $1.7 billion into the sky and then found out the telescope couldn't focus because it had a flawed mirror. What a disaster. Just after the disaster, NASA set up a failure review board. The failure review board was chaired by General Lew Allen. General Allen was very respected. He was the director of the Jet Propulsion Lab at NASA. General Allen put together a group of experts, including Charles Pellerin, because it was felt that Charles understood the entire issue, and after all, the flawed mirror was manufactured way before Charles had actually joined this team. Now, initially, the experts couldn't come up with much progress, till one person in the team figured out that the problem was something which was an adjustment error on a little device called the null corrector, which was used to understand the flaw of the mirror. This was at the vendor's location. So very quickly, the failure review board said, okay, our job is over, we figured out it's the vendor's fault. But General Allen was not satisfied with this explanation. He wanted to understand more. So he kept investigating and he found that the technicians at the vendor's end had often figured out there were hints of some problems. His question was, why did smart technical people not come up and talk about the failure? And he realized that was because they were under very, very high pressure of schedule and budgets. He wondered why these people hadn't come and talked to their counterparts at NASA. And he figured out that NASA had created such an environment of pressure and they were so hostile with their vendors that the vendors would not come up with explaining the technical problems which they could have some reason to explain away. And finally, the failure review board submitted the report which said this was a leadership failure. And Charles Pellerin, to his credit, agreed that it was his leadership failure, where he had not been able to create an environment where people, not only in his team, but with vendors, felt safe. They felt that they belonged. They felt that there was an environment where you could create, because to be creative, you need to be feeling safe about failure. Over the next few months, he and his team managed to correct the error. What a wonderful story. Where can you use this story? Well, you can use the story to say many things. One is that don't jump into the first conclusion and find the first person to lay the blame on. The blame may be elsewhere. Two, if you need creativity to happen, you need to create an environment where it'll happen. The late Sumantra Ghoshal, the professor for strategic and international management at the London Business School, in his famous speech at the World Economic Forum, had called it the smell of the place. You can watch that video on the same YouTube channel. And it is that smell of the place that leaders need to create that will give people the safety to be creative, to come back and say something is not working, something that could have stopped the $1.7 billion disaster. Let me know if you can think of some other place where we can use this story. Thanks for watching.